All right, RIT students here, they created a website to track tweets about Sandy from start to finish. We were just talking about it. The goal is to use social media to observe the geographic implications of the storm. Joining me now, Brian Schnitzer and Rob Williams. Thanks for coming on.
Oh, thank you.
So what you're doing is monitoring Sandy from where it started, where it's been, where it's going, right?
Yep. So we're taking a whole bunch of different technologies that are available on the web, such as Twitter, Google, and some information that's gathered through NOAA that Google has packaged, and kind of putting them all together within one tool that allows you to see information and data in ways that you're not able to in a normal way.
And the purpose of this is what?
It has a few different purposes. Right now, it's a prototype. Right now, we're using it to visualize what people are saying about Sandy, where they're saying it, in terms of relation to where the storm actually is. In the long term, being able to analyze these tweets and pull information about it with their geolocations is a great research tool.
Obviously, Twitter and social media has changed the way we keep records for everything. And talk more about this website, Brian, and where you hope it will go and what you hope to do with it.
So like Rob was saying, as of right now, it's more of just a demonstration, a prototyping tool. It just really displays and collects tweets. But definitely in the future, we can target it to different natural disasters, anything. Our original goal was to watch the election. But we saw Sandy, we saw the opportunity there, so we switched it over. Pretty much you can gather, we have 150,000 tweets mm-hmm. collected from Sandy. These are all geolocated tweets. So now we can take all these tweets, you know, break them down, get all sorts of information from it.
Is this a lot of work for you, or do you set up the website and does it do most of the work?
Once you set it up, it's pretty much autonomous. Like we said, in the future we want to plan to make it more, I guess, flexible. So you can say, instead of saying Sandy, we could search almost any term and you could let it run for a day and collect a whole day's worth of just data.
So will you use this as well for the election, because you mentioned that was the intent to begin with?
Yeah, I think we might repurpose this tool for other big events to see kind of what people are saying from there. We initially did it for a final project, which is due in a week or so. So Sandy came at just the perfect time for us to be able to collect this data and use it.
All right, Brian and Rob, thank you so much.
No, thank you.